Yo guys, what is up? It is Nick. We are back on Dark Souls 3, and we are going to be killing Crystal Sage today and moving on to the next area. I don't know how far we'll make it. I think I need to buy a new controller. I'm going to buy, I don't know, I might try to find a special edition online that I like or that's cool. I don't know, this controller that I have, the A button is sticky. It like sticks in. After you hit it a few times, it works. Like it functions as normal, but for some games, that's really annoying when it sticks. It's annoying, period, that it sticks, but it's like really. Where are my souls? I didn't die, did I? I don't remember. Have I died between. Yeah, I did. Let me just run around here for a second. Ignore the boss fight that's happening. I don't actually see my souls. So maybe. You give me a second to look for my. Oh, I think I've. No, that's not them. That's just a spot on the ground that kind of looks like them. Alright. Sorry, Crystal Sage. We can fight now. Where is he spawning at? Here we go. Actually, I don't do great damage. I'm not gonna say I do great damage, but it's not trash. Are we getting the multi-spawn this time? Nope, just singular. Alright, that's good. I wanna do a playthrough here with Onryu's straight sword. I don't know when I'm gonna do it, but I'm essentially just gonna play with the speedrun strats that people use to get Onryu's straight sword and be able to use it early enough. There we go. Get that out. I think that one over there is the right one, but I'm not entirely sure. I'm colorblind. You're supposed to be able to tell. Oh no, it's this one right here. You're supposed to be able to tell because it's shooting the purple magic, but I'm colorblind to like between the colors that it's shooting, so I can't really tell. It's not this one, obviously. It's not this one. Wait, is it really this one? Okay, I was gonna say, that one didn't disappear like I thought it would, so I was like, there's no way. That's a fake one. Okay, so the real one's over there. Let me heal up. I almost didn't notice that my health was this low. Come here. I swear that. Oh my gosh. Come here. Thank you. Alright, Crystal Sage dead. I don't know why I struggled with that the last time I fought him. I didn't think I died between. Maybe I. I don't know. Did I? Oh, I died to Stray Demon. I'm stupid. I died to Stray Demon. There was only like 1,000 souls in that boss room anyway. I only had 1,000 when I died. I think I had 1870. That. Wow, that one shot him. And I think maybe after I beat the cosplay with Ornstein, I think that'll be when I do the Onryu straight sword. I don't know if it'll still be any good at that point. That could also be the case. It could suck by the time they might patch Onryu straight sword. All right, now we get to kill these two NPCs. This guy guarding the ashes. Buddy. Oh, I can't get my spin off. That's the one thing I don't like about these, is that the spin, if somebody else is attacking you, their spins are actually faster than you, so. Would you stop? The spins take longer than every other weapon that's quick like this. I don't think this guy heals, so I think I can back off. Come here. No. Come here. Stop it. There we go. How many souls does he give me? Well, that's not bad, 1600. Alright, spider shield check. Come here. Come here. Ah, damn it. Why do both of you throw crap like... Wow, that special attack does like no damage. Is that like... I wonder if that attack is like... It does damage based on your intelligence or something, because that is stupid. Like, I'm never gonna use that attack. Because it does no damage. I don't know what I need to do to buff the attack of that, because that's horrible. Alright, here we go. Another part where I just run through like a pansy. We're only at 6.5 minutes. I was like, oh, maybe I'll get close to ending the episode. I'm stupid. This area, here's the second area of hell to start the game. It's this stupid area with the teleporting dogs. Okay, here we go. Teleporting dogs time. Oh, no teleporting dogs this time. They didn't patch that, I don't think. I think there's an Estus shard here. Isn't there? Isn't this an Estus shard? Give me that Estus shard. Yeah, it's an Estus shard. I can have 11 Estus flasks. Alrighty, this is beautiful. The last Estus flasks are, like, near the end, aren't they? One is by the Twin Princes. One is in Irithyll, isn't it? There's one in Irithyll, I think. And then I don't know where the other two are. I can't remember. I think one's in the catacombs. There's one in the catacombs. And then... See, I don't think there's one... I don't think there's one at Archdragon Peak, but I could be wrong. I still have yet to get those memorized. Why is my game lagging? Why am I... I look like I'm running through the swamp in that muddy area. Why am I going so slow? Oh, these idiots are blocking my path. Get out of my way. You... Oh my god, I hate these things. No, get out of the way. I don't want to fight you. I gotta grab the bone shard. I gotta remember to grab that. I gotta kill this thing because there was no rolling past that right there. Oh yeah. Oh, this area. I forgot about this. The super run area where you literally just run by everything. Large soul. What do we got here? Another large soul. Would you stop? This is always just a little bit dicey here, where you run out here and you gotta grab this. Because there are enemies here. There is a chance you get hit. We're gonna go over here. Where's that one enemy? That really strong enemy. Where's he at? Oh, the bleed is building up. Oh, yay. I didn't get away in time. The bleed is so annoying. Oh, I have these stupid shits on me. Do I have a torch? I don't have a torch. Well, shit. These things take forever to actually get off of you. Well, this is not good. I'm just gonna keep losing blood. This is annoying. I hate... I'm just gonna do this. I'm just gonna go get rid of these things. I need to go buy a torch. Let's go buy a torch. I guess I'll level up while I'm there. I need a torch, because that just gets annoying with those stupid things attached all over your character. Did some massive cleaning of my room today, like massive. I took my PS2 and my GameCube out of my room. I'm gonna put them downstairs in the collection area. I have like this collection area of games and old consoles and different stuff like that. I do play my, I'm not gonna act like I never play my old consoles, because I do. There are games that I love, like the PlayStation 2. I got rid of my original PlayStation 2, which I'm super disappointed in, because I had like some great stuff on the PlayStation 2, and I had great save files for games and stuff like that. I'm really disappointed, but I was young, and I was getting into the Xbox 360. Actually, I think I was getting into the Wii at that point. And my dad had a friend at work whose kid wanted a PS2, and they offered me like some good money. Like, I think it was like $300 for my PS2 and my I gotta run back over to him. Did I get it? I think I just did it by total habit, because that was not intended for me to give him that Estus Flash art. I totally thought I forgot. But that, yeah, for the PS2 at that time in those games, was actually extremely good. Like, that was an extremely, really, it was a generous offer. It had more to do with the fact that they knew me more than anything. That they gave me that much money for it. Okay, he's still alive. I could get the free levels.
This and I then shall be.
Alright, let's get the free levels. Put it in the strength.
Be safe.
Okay, so now we'll just jump off while I tell the story. But I got offered $300, and it made sense. It was only worth like $150. Like, that's what I would have gotten if I sold it. The guy gave my dad a generous offer, mostly because he knew him, and I don't know why. The guy that bought the PS2 for his son was pretty rich, so I think that was why. I think his wife was like a lawyer or something like that. And my dad, he wasn't really his boss, because my dad was just like the head purchasing agent at this place. It was an RV. He purchased the parts for all the RVs and stuff like that. He was just the head over it. Not that this pertains to the story, but that's what he did, and this guy was, like, one of the purchasing agents under him. But he wasn't really his boss. They were more like, they were just co-workers, really. Because, I don't know why this is relevant to the story, but I sold my PS2. I also sold my GameCube, too. I had to buy both of them back. I sold my GameCube for a decent chunk, too. I sold it on eBay. And I think I sold it for like $130, which that money paid for like the first start of my Xbox, or my Wii. My dad bought me a Wii, but I bought games for it, and you know, such like that, and controllers and all that different stuff. And then I moved over to the Xbox 360, and now on to the Xbox One. And then soon, really soon, this summer, I'm gonna get a PlayStation 4. Because there are games on the PlayStation 4 I want to play, like Bloodborne, Ratchet & Clank, Gran Turismo. Gran Turismo is like the shit. That's what I like grew up playing. I had a friend named Luke, and that's like, him and his dad were really into it, and he got me into playing it, but we used to just have like sleepovers and stuff, and we would play Gran Turismo. And we'd even sometimes, his dad would play with us. It was kind of cool. But back to the story. I was cleaning out my room, getting all my game stations downstairs so that I could free up some room. I really need to free up even more room up. I have this, my dad built me, he's like a, he does woodwork, it's like his hobby. He built me this desk for my Xbox and all the stuff like that. But I wish it was a little bit bigger because it could almost fit the third console per shelf. But it only fits two, really. It's just a little bit smaller than it needs to be just a little bit bigger, but it's actually really nicely made, and it's made out of oak, and it looks really nice. So I love it, and it fits my TV really well and all of that stuff. But I need to clear out space to do my PS4. I died enough, I think I can go. I've been like telling the story and just jumping off to my death.
I then
I should probably do this off video, but I thought I might as well just do it on camera
be
this time.
safe.
Because the couple of playthroughs, I've done it off camera. So, thought I'd do this one on camera while I told stories of my past and how I gaming and all that different stuff. I was actually kind of late into gaming. I think it was like 7 or 8 before I even got into gaming. My neighbor down the street actually gave me his NES, was it NES, I think. I don't even have I should have it. I think I lost it in the move. I lost a box of stuff in the move. Actually some valuable stuff like Star Wars Tactics. I don't know if anybody knows what those are. But I had a really, really nice collection of those. I had like the rare Yoda figure and a couple of other guys. I had like a ton of the tactics. Like I had complete sets and all that different stuff. I lost those. I don't remember what the name of the game was. It was like a Dungeons and Dragons type game. But I had a lot of cool stuff for that, and I had like a castle and all these different things for that that I. When I was a kid, I didn't really play so much video games as I did play with like toys and stuff, and I had like Bionicles. I just lost a. It was a really big box. It's not like your generic box of stuff that. I actually think I can go draw out another level. It's not like your generic stuff that you usually have in a box at when you move. That wasn't a
I
small box. It was a
then shall
really
be.
big box. But I lost a ton of stuff, and I was like,
Be safe.
I'm still annoyed that I don't have it. I don't know where it is. Like, I don't know what happened to it. Like, I thought I moved all my electronics when we moved. We moved about like 6 years ago. And I moved all my electronics in my dad's car because I was like, yeah, I don't trust anybody with my electronics except myself. So I ended up moving all of that stuff. And I put the stupid stuff in a giant box. And I don't know how you lose a giant box. Like, I don't know how shit gets lost when you move. It just happens. Shit just gets lost. And I don't get it. But I don't know how I got started on all of this, but long story short, I cleaned out my room and I need to clean it out more to fit a PlayStation 3 when I get or PlayStation 4. I need to buy a PlayStation 3 too. Because I do love some games on the PlayStation 3 and they're pretty cheap now. PS4 is actually pretty cheap. It's like $300 at GameStop, so I'll pick it up. I could get it cheaper online. I do understand that. Could get it cheaper on like eBay or something like that. But I always just buy my new stuff from GameStop or Best Buy. It's easier. Just go down there. I know the people at GameStop and Best Buy. And so I just go down there. I know it's not the most cost-effective way. And I like to have physical copies of games. I don't like downloading games on dashboard and stuff like that, even though for such as Dark Souls 3 and a few other games, I'm not able to get them at midnight. So I kind of get screwed out of getting midnight games, but that's all right. I don't know if
I
I've died.
then shall bear.
I think I could draw my strength out one more time
Be safe.
by upgrading these. No, it's still a descaling. Descaling sucks. I want some like A scaling. I need to kill myself two more times, and I think we're good. Also, now I'm annoyed because one time I did buy my Estus Flask Edition off of Amazon. It did come, but when the Xbox One was coming out, I bought it off of Amazon, and they sent me a freaking PlayStation 4 with like six games, and I was like, "What the hell is this?" And then they wanted to charge me for the 6 games. They were like, "Oh, we noticed that we sent you these," which I wanted to tell them, "You fucked up. That's on you." But they were like, "We sent you these 6 games, and they weren't supposed to be sent to you, so you can send them back. You can pay for them." And they like charged my bank account, and they said, "We'll refund the money when you send them back." And I was like, "You didn't even send me the right thing to begin with." And then they wouldn't send me the Xbox One. They were like, "Oh, we're all sold out." And so I had to go. Because the PlayStation 4 came out 1 week before the Xbox One, right? I think I should be able to just jump onto this and kill myself. So I had to go, and I had because you could pre-order the Xbox Ones at that point, a little late. So I had to sit at my local GameStop for like 6 hours until they closed. I was third in line. There was an old man who was getting it for his son, which I thought was pretty cool. He sat in line forever with us. We didn't actually sit in line. I sat on the floor because they just knew who came there first. But I literally just had to sit there forever. I got so sick and tired of being at GameStop. But I got my Xbox One day one, and that's really all that mattered.
I then shall.
Right, let me upgrade my strength.
Be safe.
I think
Oh,
that's all five.
oh.
Yeah. Now Yuria will spawn. I don't think I'll do the special ending. I might, I don't know. Who knows? Alright, so now we can head out. I'm gonna run through the area and get all the different stuff here before I call it an episode. Cleansing Chapel. I think I've got time. I wanna cut this episode. I like to cut my episode somewhere around 30 minutes, but doesn't always happen. All right. So run back through. I've got my torch now, which is the most important thing. I actually want to just put the torch at my side. Actually, I don't want anything. Put these on. Switch to them. I don't know why I'm OCD like this. No, I don't have anything on my back. I don't want anything out of my back because I like how the dancers. My favorite part of the dancer's armor is the veil, and if you have something on your back, you don't really see the veil. I need to pop an ember. So we will do this while I'm running around here. There we go. I'll kill these things again. Go. Alright, let's go down and do what I wanted to do last time, but I didn't get to do because I got stupid blood loss, and I didn't want to just get blood lost for like 10 minutes while I was running around down there. Let me grab these young white birches. Alright, we're just gonna have to deal with something on my back because I'm gonna need this thing. There was this beefy guy. You wanna fight my dual swords against yours? God, this is such a cramped area right there. Come down here so I can at least fight you. And wait, it didn't die? That didn't kill it? That's ridiculous. That's ridiculous that that didn't die from that. That was a heck of a fall. All right, I think this will give me two Titanite scales, hopefully. Could only be one, which would really suck. And that was a lot of damage before he even got up. Okay, can I get the rep? I can never get the riposte. I stun him again? I stunned him again. I didn't get the riposte again! Why does this game hate me? And you're dead. Oh, it only gave me one Titanite scale. That really sucks. Alright, maggot thing. Get lit on fire. 10,000 souls. Level up again, I guess. I thought I might as well get those five free souls. What's up here? Is there any? No, that doesn't. I don't understand that. I think they should have put the crystal beast. I think that's what they're called. When it's those. These are Titanite or these are crystal lizards. That's, I think, a Titanite. It's either a Titanite demon or Titanite beast, I think. I probably don't know what the hell I'm talking about. No, come here. Really? Come here. There you go. Twinkling, I wish you guys dropped dragon scales. Really, that didn't burn you? Would you just get burned and die? Saint Tree Belvine. There we go. Alright, now we're just gonna get on our horse and run to the bonfire. To run for the is it the shortcut first? I think it's shortcut. There isn't a bonfire, I don't think. The Cleansing Chapel is the only bonfire, really, for this area. If I'm not mistaken. I haven't played this in a while, I'm starting to forget. Which seems ridiculous, because I've played through it so many times, I've watched so many playthroughs of it, that I actually forget, kind of, what some of this stuff is. Let's see here, put these on. I want to try the twin daggers out at some point, but I just haven't had the chance to really give them a solid go. There's a lot of weapons, like the Grave Warden twin blades. I think those are what those are called. I kind of want to try those out. There's a ton of good weapons that I want to try out, but I just never can. Alright, hopefully I can get this running down. I don't exactly remember where the shortcut is. I know how to get to the I know which way to go, so that's not, like, the issue. But I'm seriously, I'm just getting on my horse and I'm running. I do want this item here. Yeah, give me a hug. Yep. Oh god. Would you. You dicks! Fuck all of you. I swear if I would have died there, I would have lost my mind. I got headshotted, then I got hit. Oh no! And then I got hit again by an arrow. And then I got headshotted by an arrow. That was just a ridiculous. Like, look at these. I got like three arrows in my head, I've got two in the body. Yeah, light yourself on fire. Whatever. Open this door. Okay! Would you just die? Heal up. Go over here and grab this item. My other computer just turned on. I don't know why. That was like something. It was creepy when it turned on. I should do a setup video, because sometimes I talk about my setup and I'm like, oh, no one knows what I'm talking about. Where is the shortcut? Forget where the shortcut is. Well, we're just running. Ah, here it is. It's like, I knew it had to be coming. Pop the door open. And back to the bonfire. So I think that's gonna do it for this episode, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. Drop a like if you did, subscribe if you haven't, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode of the playthrough, where we will be going and probably, I think we'll be able to kill the Deacons of the Deep in the next episode. So I will catch you all then. Peace out.